mic back on.
Violence that continues to kill trans people.
particularly trans people of color. Our brothers and sisters in our community continue to lose their lives to structural, institutional, physical, and relationship violence. We, the trans community, invite the LGBTQ community and allied institutions at this conference to join us in putting an end to the violence that our community has experienced for many, many years. We're here demanding intentional, meaningful investment in our community. And in our community efforts to end this motherfucking epidemic. LGBT and other organizations need to hire trans people and less and give us leadership positions within those organizations. And truly provide leadership opportunities for the trans community. If you serve us, you need to include us. We demand investment in new and upcoming trans-specific organizations and support our work and in underserved areas. We demand by 10 and non-core organizations to leverage their access to policymakers and funders and use their privilege to support trans-led efforts and eradicate the ongoing structural violence that our community faces. This needs to stop, and we are calling on all of you to make it stop. It is your responsibility to come with us, unite with us, and make a stronger movement.
All right, let's back up. Back up.
You just like.
Thank you. All right, we are standing here today and mourning and honoring the loss of Jesse Hernandez. Yes. All right, we stand here sharing our collective voice because this could have happened to any of us. Yes. The recent murder of Jesse Hernandez is not an isolated incident. It is the most recent event of how DPD is targeting and profiling queer youth of color in Denver. We welcome you to Denver, a city that is mourning the loss of a sister, a warrior, a lover, and a fellow queer person whose life was taken last Monday at the hands of Denver police. We see this as hypocritical that the mayor of Denver, the city with the second highest rate of police killings in the country, would be invited here to welcome y'all to Denver. Allies and supporters, remember that queer youth of color who have been, since the beginning of colonization, organizing to end the violence and criminalization that has plagued us ever since, ever since colonization happened. So, yeah, that's the end of my speech, sorry.
So, we really need to honor our young people, really. We will not continue to go on like this. We owe this to them. They are our future. And it's our responsibility to take care of our future. Take care of our young people.
We are the future and we are today. We are here today. Survivors of police brutality, especially here in Denver, and that is why we wanted to come up here and address everybody, because the police brutality is so high here in Denver. Please recognize that while you're here in our city. Young people are criminalized and targeted by DPD on the daily. Please remember that while you're in our city. If you see cop interactions, please cop watch. We ask you to do that. En México, en Ayotzinapa. Para toda la gente en el pueblo de Palestina. Todos los que están en Ferguson y están en Nueva York. Toda la gente que los buses están siempre ya empujados al lado. Ya no basta.
Y es nuestra responsabilidad seguir adelante. Todos juntos, sí podemos. ¿Se puede?
¡Sí se puede!
¡Se puede!